20 years ago, Robert Randall made history. He became the first American to obtain legal access to federally produced supplies of marijuana. He used the drug to ease the symptoms of his glaucoma. Last week, here in California and also in Arizona, propositions were passed which will allow the medical use of marijuana. It's an issue that Robert Randall has been at the center of for many, many years, and I'm happy to welcome him to CBS tonight. Thanks for coming over. Briefly, this battle that you fought 20 years ago when I first met you, what did you have to prove, and how did you prove it?
I had to prove that marijuana was the only drug that would help me not go blind. And thankfully was able to do that through going through a number of research programs and having a judge that would pay attention to what the researchers were saying.
Right, and so they supplied you with an amount of marijuana joints, weekly, monthly, or whatever, to ease glaucoma, reduce the pressure, and allow you to keep your eyesight.
That's right.
And how is your eyesight? How many fingers am I holding up?
let's see. No, it's worked very well. No one would have believed 20 years ago I'd still be walking around seeing.
And were there any others who were given these joints by the government because of the stand that you took and the proof that you offered that it could help glaucoma?
A large number of people in several state programs were given access to marijuana between the late 70s and early 80s. Unfortunately, those programs were shut down. There are about 8 other people in the United States right now who still have legal access to marijuana. Several of them have glaucoma. Several of them have multiple sclerosis. Mm-hmm. And others have other spasm disorders.
Could somebody still apply to get what you get, or is it all over?
No, they shut the program down. The government doesn't want to know the answer to does marijuana have medical value.
Mm-hmm. The old head's still in the sand, huh?
The whole, yes, if that's where it is.
I was trying to be polite, you know.
It's still there.
Yeah, I got you.
And I think the initiative in California was important because it indicated that everyone is fed up with this policy. There have been 35 state laws passed recognizing marijuana's medical value. A number of court cases like mine have been resolved in favor of people using marijuana medically. The DEA's own chief administrative law judge said the current policy is crazy and marijuana should be legally available by prescription like morphine or any other prescribed
drug.
And
would you want to be available through the government, through a prescription?
I think it's wise at the outset.
Or through a drug company.
Well, the government knows how to make marijuana cigarettes.
Oh, wait, hold that. Look how beautifully that thing is rolled. I mean, no. Remember how they used to be all squiggled up, you know, and funny looking, and there's no seeds falling out of it. I mean, it's perfect.
It's perfect.
In every regard, yeah.
So they know how to do it.
Yeah. Can you spare a smoke?
That's right. And at the outset, I think it would be wise to leave it in the government's hands.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, federal agencies for 20 years have been telling lies. Marijuana has no medical value, pay no attention, man behind the curtain, all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the people of California, and especially of Arizona, sent a very clear message they're not buying the lie. I think the interesting thing was the initiative passed in conservative Arizona by 2-1. There are a lot of seniors who don't believe the federal government should interfere with their medical care.
Let me ask you about your years treating your glaucoma with marijuana. Mm-hmm. Do you smoke a lot of that stuff every day or just a couple?
10 marijuana cigarettes a day.
Uh-huh. And were you able to function and whatever your job was okay?
Wrote 6 books, got people through a complex federal system. Right. Yeah, there's no problem.
Okay, and then a couple of years ago, in 1984, you found out you had AIDS.
1994,
I'm sorry, 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And how severe was the AIDS? How full-blown was it?
I was diagnosed very full-blown. No one's going to tell you how long do you have to live.
Right.
But I was told to go home and make out my will. And it was good advice. I spent almost all of 95 trying very hard to die, literally being hooked up to hoses.
Well, you had major surgery. You got pancreatitis.
Major surgery, pancreatitis, which is a gruesomely painful condition. Thank God for morphine. And even until March of this year, my immune system was nowhere. I simply had no immune system. But I began using new antiviral therapies, and I began smoking marijuana again.
Now, when you quit smoking marijuana, what was the reason that you quit?
I was so ill that I literally was bedbound.
Gotcha.
There was no reason to smoke marijuana. I was out of here.
Okay.
Keeping my eyesight intact was the least of my problems.
And how long were you off the marijuana smoke?
For a year.
And what happened to your eyesight? Anything?
Lost more eyesight in that year than in the previous 20 years. But began as my vital signs stabilized in March or April of this year, I began using marijuana and the new antiviral therapies. So, you know, I'm on cutting-edge medical therapy, which actually seems to be working. My immune system's beginning to repair itself. But I've also gained 50 pounds in the last 6 months because marijuana has helped control the nausea and the vomiting that many patients experience, like cancer patients.
From the AIDS drugs.
From the AIDS drugs. So, and one of the reasons I decided it was time to speak out again was because I was in clinic one day. The doctor and the nurse who saved my life were saying what an amazing recovery I was making. Mm-hmm. And, you know, my response was, aren't all people on antivirals doing this well? And their response was, no, yeah. Up to 40% can't tolerate the side effects. The side effects being nausea, vomiting, and the inability to eat.
And how many of those have access to legal marijuana?
None.
And if they did have access to it, the question is, would they share the recovery, the obvious recovery, recovery that you have made, 50 pounds?
That's right.
I mean, you appear to be in good health. Your color is good. Your vital signs look good to me.
Yeah. And you know, this is not only a problem of AIDS patients, but of cancer patients.
Of course.
We've all seen cancer patients literally waste away. You know, no one knows whether the chemotherapy will work. No one knows what the long-term outcome of antiviral therapies will be. But if you can keep going through the therapy, you have a better chance of surviving. And if you can get through that therapy with the munchies, you know, this is basic, folks.
Are you getting a little hungry?
That's right. You know, the munchies can be a lifesaver if you're unintentionally anorexic. I hope the message out of California isn't to, you know, trigger a little cultural warfare where we've got all the culture clowns, you know, the vice cops, the drug dealers, the drug czar. You know, it's time to move beyond that and just address the question. You know, pictures fly through the air. We're smart enough to figure out if marijuana has medical value.
Let me get to Kathy here in Newtown Square, Pennsylvania. Hi, Kathy. Tom here. Welcome to CBS.
Hi, Tom.
Hello.
Hi. I just wanted to ask your guest, years ago I used to smoke marijuana, and I would find that after just a few puffs on one marijuana cigarette, I was good for nothing.
And then you shouldn't smoke.
I just had, like, apathy, lethargy, lack of motivation. I usually would smoke it, like, late at night on a Friday or Saturday.
Right.
So that I could just have
the apathetic and lethargic.
Yes.
Yeah, so what's the question, Kathy, because I'm running short on time, Laura.
How could he possibly function on 10 marijuana cigarettes a day?
Well, you know, Kathy, after 20 years, you build up a little bit of resistance.
A little bit of resistance. I mean, you know, the high is elusive. If you smoke once every week, maybe you'll get high. If you smoke every day, you get less high.
Is that right?
Yeah. I mean, there's no problem here. But I think she made the right decision for herself as she decided to quit using.
Oh, listen, Kathy, I share your feeling. I mean, two puffs and I was everybody's. I mean, anyway, I'm glad you called, Kathy, and I hope you're well.
Thank you.
All right. Good night now.
Good night.
It's been a long time since I've seen you. You look wonderful, and continued good health to you, sir.
Thank you.
And take care.
I hope.
Okay. Robert Randall is the guest, the first person in America to be given marijuana joints by the government of the United States. And as I told him last night, government stuff is good stuff, huh?
Pretty good stuff.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You can get better.
You old sweet talker, you. Back after these messages. Robert, thanks.